A robotic lunar lander is en route to the moon right now, with a scheduled landing only a few weeks away. So today, I wanted to give a progress update on the Blue Ghost Lander by private American rocket company Firefly Aerospace. But first, let's briefly explore its origins within NASA's Commercial Lunar Payload Services program, or the CLPS program. NASA established the CLPS program in 2018 to figure out a way to affordably get payloads to the moon and gain as much scientific and engineering experience as possible before they send astronauts back to the moon. These precursor missions have lots of potential, not just for the data, but for determining how and where we might build a lunar base. They could also deliver equipment for use by lunar astronauts with future plans for bigger and more capable landers. But for now, these small landers are providing valuable experience to NASA and their commercial partners. In February of 2021, Firefly was awarded a CLPS contract to deliver a suite of NASA payloads to the moon. And in order to fulfill this mission, Firefly developed the Blue Ghost Lunar Lander, named after an insect species of firefly, actually, which I believe was pronounced Phasis reticulata, which glows blue, or green, and is commonly called the Blue Ghost in the southern United States. Hopefully, knowing that little bit of trivia helps avoid confusing Blue Ghost with Blue Origin's lunar lander called Blue Moon. One of these things is not like the other. Anyway, Firefly's lander has been designed to meet NASA's requirements for lunar delivery and operations, and NASA has already ordered two more landers of this class from Firefly. So, regardless of the outcome of this mission, it won't be the last that we see of lunar landers from Firefly Aerospace. Blue Ghost was successfully launched on January 15, 2025 from NASA's Kennedy Space Center aboard a Falcon 9 rocket on a piggyback mission with another lunar lander by a Japanese company called iSpace, which we're going to talk about in depth in a later video. After Blue Ghost separated from the rocket, the lander established communication with Firefly's Mission Control Center in Cedar Park, Texas. During the first couple of weeks of its journey, Blue Ghost has been performing multiple tests of all of its systems and verifying that everything is working with communication, power generation, capturing awesome images and video of Earth, and maybe most importantly, verifying that its engines work. 4 days into the mission, on January 18th, 2025, Blue Ghost completed its initial main engine burn, marking the first of several maneuvers to position the lander on its correct trajectory towards the moon. After almost 2 weeks in Earth orbit, on January 29th, Blue Ghost successfully executed its second engine burn, placing the lander in the correct position to leave Earth's orbit and continue its journey to the moon. Something that I have really appreciated is the fact that Firefly has been providing weekly video updates online and having a little bit of fun along the way.
Why is it so hard for people to understand our orbit?
Because they're not rocket scientists. Let's pretend this is Blue Ghost.
Okay, would you stand over here? You're the moon.
Who are you again?
I'm Jason, the CEO of Firefly.
Right, okay, would you stand here, please? You'll be the Earth. We start in orbit for 25 days around the Earth, or the CEO. We perform a few burns to change the duration of each orbit on the way to the moon. We then perform the translunar injection to escape Earth's gravitational pull and begin our 4-day transit to the moon. And as we approach the moon's orbit, we perform a braking burn, pull the e-brake for lunar orbit insertion. We only have one shot at this, but we've been perfecting our systems the whole transit so far, so we gotta get this right. Once we're in the moon's orbit, we'll perform a few more phasing burns to lower our orbit, just like we did for translunar injection around Earth. And lunar phasing puts us exactly over our landing site at exactly the right time we need to land, sunrise. And as the lunar day begins, we'll begin our descent by firing all of our engines to begin our landing on the moon. Done the math. It checks out.
Joe?
Yes, sir?
Get out.
All right.
Honestly, I love this, and I want to see a lot more goofiness like this from other companies. I'm definitely using that as a meme anytime that we have bad ideas, which is pretty frequently. Seriously, though, I love how much Firefly has been sharing their progress every single step of the way. On February 8th, Blue Ghost performed the all-important lunar injection burn successfully, propelling it out of Earth's orbit and setting it on a four-day course towards the moon. Following this, the lander executed a trajectory correction maneuver on February 9th of 2025 to ensure that it remains on the correct path. Interestingly, Firefly had planned on doing two course correction maneuvers, but the first one went so well, the companies determined that a second course correction wasn't necessary, as all of their navigation equipment was telling them that they were already on track for a lunar orbital capture. And just yesterday, on February 12th, Blue Ghost entered into orbit of the moon. That's awesome. It's going to remain there for the next 15 days and finish calibrating and ensuring that it has the best approach to its target landing site. All of the NASA payloads on board are currently healthy and ready for surface operations on the moon. In fact, they've already been conducting science and verified that a gravitational field sensor is working and that it can tell the difference between Earth's gravitational field and the moon's gravitational field. This is great. They've also verified that a special computer system built to withstand high amounts of radiation worked perfectly as the lander passed through the Van Allen radiation belts of Earth. Now, even though the lander is called Blue Ghost, this mission is actually called Ghost Riders in the Sky, and it's going to deliver 10 NASA instruments in total to the lunar surface as part of the whole CLIPS program initiative. These instruments are going to conduct various experiments, including investigating heat flow from the lunar interior using a drill, studying the moon's magnetic and electric fields, analyzing the interaction between the Earth's magnetosphere and the solar wind, and examining how lunar dust adheres or sticks to different materials, with a sample palette of very different material samples to help us understand what we should and shouldn't be making future lunar equipment with, whether it be the spacesuits, lunar rovers, or habitats at a crewed lunar base. But an experiment that I'm most excited about is the electrodynamic dust shield, which is going to generate an electric field using varying high voltage on multiple electrodes, and this traveling electric field in turn is going to carry away lunar dust particles, which could be super helpful in the future for thermal radiators, the spacesuit fabrics, visors, camera lenses, solar panels, and a whole lot more, so that we can keep that equipment clean and operational without the harsh lunar regolith damaging stuff. One way or another, these experiments are going to provide valuable insights to support future lunar exploration, if the landing is successful. As of right now, Blue Ghost is scheduled to land in Mare Crisium on March 2nd, 2025, which is just a couple of weeks away. Upon landing, the instruments will operate for a full lunar day, or approximately 14 Earth days, conducting their respective investigations. Obviously, we are rooting for a successful landing and hope that all of the instruments do their intended jobs and send back data and pictures and video back to Earth. We're really excited about this, and this mission represents a significant milestone in commercial lunar exploration. It's contributing essential data, technology, and experience that's going to pave the way for future missions to the moon, to Mars, to Venus, maybe even dangerous asteroids out there that we have to do something about in order to protect life here on Earth. This is great. As for Firefly Aerospace, in the future, their next Blue Ghost lander is planned to launch sometime next year in 2026, and their final lander in 2028, which, if everything goes well for Firefly's rocket programs, the company might be launching themselves instead of getting a ride to space on a Falcon 9 rocket. And who knows, if everything goes really well with these landers, Firefly may get another contract for bigger landers to support a permanently crewed base on the lunar surface. Right now, the direction of the American space program is a bit in limbo at the moment, but whether we stay on our current course or switch gears to something else, I personally believe that missions like this are leading humanity in the right direction. And I sincerely hope that we continue to innovate and make progress on Earth and in space to create a better tomorrow for all of us. Well, thank you very much for watching this video. That's it for today's update on the Blue Ghost Lander, but stay tuned for more coverage of this as it gets closer towards its landing and other exciting space missions that we'll be talking about in the future. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell to stay informed about all the latest developments in space exploration. And let us know what you think about this mission in the comments. I'm really looking forward to hearing what you guys have to say about this. Until next time, though, keep moving onwards and upwards, everybody, and don't forget, Ad Astra, to the stars.